meeting, a public meeting, and it will be filmed. Two newspapers are here, Independent and the Daily Sun. So anything that is said, you may see in the paper or on video. It's common practice now for commissioners' meetings to have these people present. Right to know law and everything else goes with it. You passing around an attendance sheet?
Yes.
Great, thank you, Kathy. I'm glad Milton Borough Selectmen, we have a person in the name of Kathy Geary who comes from Milton Borough, and she's well-respected and...
Yes, she is.
Very trustworthy and a good person to have, especially in the financial office. Well, let me start by, while we're sort of waiting for Commissioner Kenny to come back. We received a letter, I believe, signed by all three towns, selectmen or managers, concerning the dispatch, realizing that each of your three towns pay for the dispatching of your own people. We dispatch, or the Sheriff's Department dispatches for all the other towns in the county. Keeping in mind that that dispatch center that we have at the county level is available to all towns. Whether you decide to take advantage of that, that's up to individual towns to do that. I understand where you're coming from, that some towns are paying a lot of dollars for the coverage to dispatch your own. I also understand that several towns have mutual agreements with other towns, perhaps outside the counties, in the case of Milton Borough. And so that creates a problem also in dispatching, whether we dispatch it or you do. Years ago, I remember that the offer was made to Milton Borough in particular. At that point in time, I think the savings was going to be somewhere around $90,000 should Milton Borough decide to come and let the county dispatch for them. They apparently decided not to do that. The other two towns, Wolfboro and Conway, I don't know if an offer was ever made or is, maybe this is the first time that it was ever brought up regarding the dispatching. So that's where the county is coming from. I would assume that after the commissioners take any action, that it would then go to the delegation, representatives representing Carroll County, and the decision would be made by them. They make the financial decisions, and if we did it, we would have to come up with another, I think this document here says $60,000 to do the job for the other three towns. And also they act on our budget, so that should they agree to give you a tax break or whatever you're looking for, that would increase our budget somewhere, so they ultimately would be the responsible organization that would make the final decision. Okay. That said, I would open it up to anybody that, if you have a spokesperson or if you want to speak individual towns, feel free to, we'll have a fair and even discussion about what's going on, okay? We'll hold the papers off until we hear from those concerned.
Do you want to wait for the other commissioner?
Okay, we'll wait. Thank you.
Just
thank you. I'm going to have to say it again.
The other commissioner to come back.
Do you want me to call down?
I saw her go downstairs.
Yeah, no, do you want me to call down and see?
She knows
she
we're
has
meeting.
To be here. Coffee cup in the winter.
Could we do introductions?
Okay.
Before we call.
We'll do that. And we've got a sign-up sheet going around, so we'll know. Lieutenant, did you pass out this document to everybody?
That was from the sheriff to the commissioners. The sheriff wanted to leave it up to the commissioners what they would do with it. So I do have enough copies for each town if you'd like them to have them.
Well, I think we ought to have a copy for everybody.
Yeah, he's not opposed to it. He just wanted it to be your decision. That's all.
Yeah. We asked the sheriff to what would it cost the county if we did it for everybody. And so this document talks about the problems, difficulties, and what it would cost and so forth for the county to do it. And your letter is also included in here. Where the heck did she go?
She went down.
She's downstairs. I asked them to have reminder.
I saw her go in the elevator. I don't know. Sandwiches in here. I don't see sandwiches.
Sandwiches is a mutual agreement, I think, with Marlboro?
No. State police.
With whom?
State police.
With state police?
State police.
Everybody does their own.
So if they have a fire in Sandwich, what's the backup?
Sandwich, I think.
Tamworth?
Carter might know better than me. I think Sandwich goes through Lakes Region
they
as well.
For fire.
But police, they go through Troop A. They work a lot with Marlboro. I think their primary is Troop B.
The sheriff apparently had another commitment. He was invited to this meeting, and he sent this memorandum through the lieutenant. Anybody have a chance to go through the new nursing home? You did.
Yeah.
What did you think?
I thought it was very lovely. Nice space.
Good.
I went when you had the open house.
Oh, you did? Oh,
yeah,
good.
Yes.
Good.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I was there too.
Okay. If you have time.
Is going to be done with the old one yet?
Still working on it.
We're still working on it. Delegation couldn't come up with the 2/3 vote to do something with it, so it just stays just the way it is. We have pellet furnaces in there that are online that are providing hot water for our nursing home. That's the small pellet furnace. The larger one will come online. Well, it's ready to come online, but the demand isn't there. Come on when the cold weather comes, so that we pick it up. Right now, the only propane we're using is for the gas stoves in the nursing home, in the kitchen. So hopefully we're saving money. We also went into a pool with other counties regarding energy savings on electricity. Because we're in a pool, we get a cheaper rate. So we're looking at that. That's in the works.
Have you seen a increase in the number of beds being filled, which was one of the things that you thought when you went to single rooms, you wouldn't have empty beds because of male, female?
I'm glad you asked that, because today, as other days, the director of the nursing home has reported 103 beds filled.
No,
and that's what we have, is 103.
We have 101.
Do we have?
Two people are on leave at the moment, remember.
I thought two people, okay.
101.
The beds are accounted for. We can hold the beds 10 days.
Okay.
If they have to go to the hospital.
Yeah.
And then they either private pay or we turn the bed over to somebody else.
And do you still have a long waiting list?
We have a waiting list, yes. Yep. Yep.
Thank you.
Now, let's say 4 or 5 years ago, we probably had 96 beds, maybe 97 beds filled.
Mm-hmm.
So we were losing $200 and some a day for those empty beds,
mm-hmm.
per day, per individual, losing a lot of money. Our new director, I say new, I think she's been with us 2 years.
Mm-hmm.
She has done a fantastic job. I'm not so sure that she has done it, but at least she has supervised the people to make sure that the beds are filled. So I'm pleased with the filling of the beds, because we're showing more income than we had in the past.
That's good.
Yeah, that is good.
Yeah.
I'm embarrassed to hold this meeting up for a commission that had an opportunity to use the facilities, but I would say let's go for it, and let's discuss what the issues are, and whoever wants to speak and start off.
We also lost the lieutenant too.
That's terrible.
He's on the phone, as I see. I don't have no idea what he's.
Let's go. Commissioner Kenny will have to catch up. Anybody want to start?
Sure. My name's Carter Terenzini. I'm the town administrator in Moultonboro. Thank you for having us over today. We sent a letter over sometime early in March, as I recall it, outlining some concerns that the three towns that signed the letter have. Chairman Joel Mudgett, on behalf of the town of Moultonboro, and at the time it was Sarasota, but Linda Murray is now the chairman of the Wolfboro Select Board, and Dave Weathers with the Conway Board of Selectmen. The dispatch center, as you know, does more service than just for the sheriff's department itself. It serves a multiple number of other agencies.
Mm-hmm.
It does not serve all the other agencies within the county. Whether or not it can, within the numbers that are in the letter from the sheriff, without a change to existing infrastructure, certainly something we could explore and discuss.
Mm-hmm.
This is not at all consistent with previous information that's been supplied to us, and I won't try to go there. I just want to touch upon the basics.
Okay.
Unlike the sheriff's side of the dispatch center, which serves all towns in the
mm-hmm.
county,
mm-hmm.
which we all agree we should pay our fair share of, it also serves a number of local communities out of the county tax only, thereby relieving them of having to expend local tax levy out of the town tax rate.
Mm-hmm.
And we think that's an inherent unfairness. We believe that in the absence of the facility being able to serve everyone, setting aside whether or not everyone wants to be served, that we should definitely look at how to make this more equitable. Now, we've given you, attached to our letter, a chart of how some of the other counties service it, and I've only had a very quick opportunity to look at the sheriff's letter here, but our understanding is that four of the counties currently serve that, what I'm going to call that up service, that value-added service. Four counties currently charge the local communities for that on some formula, and several others are actually looking at doing that. This is not to say that those communities don't need service and don't deserve service. We just believe that a service that is not available countywide should not be paid countywide out of the property taxes of everybody. And we're here to ask you to consider putting together a working group to explore the inequity and how that might be addressed. And I would stop there just asking if, you know, any of the select board members or my colleague would like to add anything to that. And I think that's a fair representation of what we've been saying.
Clarification on one sentence. Near the end, you said that we provide services that aren't available countywide.
That's correct.
And what is that?
You could not dispatch for Moultonboro today if we called you, and it is our understanding that if we called you, even if you added some staff, you could not dispatch for Moultonboro on an ongoing, reliable basis. And until such services are available to all on an ongoing, reliable basis, we believe there's an inequity.
Could you document why you think it's not reliable?
I think this has been transformed over a period of time. I worked at Conway for a number of years. Mm-hmm. Moultonboro and Wolfboro decided to have their own dispatch, and it's transformed over a number of years. So the county has transformed with the existing towns and what their services and needs were at the time. If Moultonboro, as you know, you came searching a little while ago, wanted to switch over to county dispatch, you know, I'm positive that we would start making the adjustments. Could it happen overnight? Absolutely not. We'd have to hire staff and maybe expand the infrastructure and add some phone lines and make sure that everything's all set. But it can happen. But if Moultonboro or Conway still chooses to have their own, that's, you know, and that's probably in the best interest of your town. I'm just saying that I think your statement was a little overbroad. We can accommodate that. We can't accommodate it tomorrow, but we can, if you come to us and say we have this need, we can move forward to it and see it and look at the viability.
Well, setting aside whether or not all towns would want to partake about it, let's talk about the functional utility of being able to do it. And no disrespect to you, this is you are not the person that we had these discussions with back in the day, some 18 months or so ago. At the time, if we had wanted to, we were told by your predecessor that without substantial investment in infrastructure and then staffing, and we had the same discussion with the supplier who manages our radio system, Ospe Mountain Electronics, you cannot dispatch to Moultonboro on a consistent, reliable basis. And I can set those issues apart, but until such time as you could dispatch countywide to everyone, we think there's an inherent inequity in us providing our own local dispatch, being unable to turn ourselves over to you for local dispatch, should we want to, and then us taxing our local taxpayers for that, and then other communities being able to get their dispatch essentially assisted with our dimes. We think there's an inequity there, and that should be looked at.
And I agree with what you said. That being said, did my predecessor tell you that we wouldn't be willing to explore the possibility, or did you choose to take and continue to go down the avenue that you are and keep the dispatch the way it is?
The representation that was made to us was that the infrastructure costs and the staffing costs were so large, particularly given that you can't even hit our receiver towers and then repeat through the community on a reliable basis, that this was not a practical thing to do at all. And until such time as you know, and I'm going to sound like a broken record here, truly, because you can't right now dispatch for everybody, even if they all wanted to. And until such time as you can either offer that service.
So what you want to
say. At which point there would be equity and we could then make our own local decisions. You know, that's certainly something the boards could talk about. But until such time as you reach that point of equity, we simply think it's inequitable to be charging the three of us so that taxpayers in a number of other communities are getting their local dispatch services provided out of the county tax base that we're paying in on. And so I think that, you know, from my position, we should either look at a way of establishing fee for service and those that want to be in can be in, those that don't want to be in don't have to be in, or you need to find a way to make this equitable to everybody, and then we'll make our own local decisions of what we want to do. So and I don't want to be the only one speaking here because there are other towns.
I don't want to be the only one speaking either, but so what you're saying is until such time that our dispatch center can expand enough to dispatch for all towns in the county, it's inherently inequitable. So if we, so you would want us to go out and spend a large sum of money to expand our services out to where we can handle the whole county, and then you're going to come back to us and say whether you want us to dispatch for you.
I will just say from my perspective, I think you need to explore making this equitable early.
Could I, before we go any further, could I get an estimate as to what it costs your dispatch, each of the towns' dispatch, right now? I know in Moultonboro years ago it was $90,000. County could have saved you. I'm sure it's a lot more than that now.
That was for fire.
Excuse me?
That was for fire.
Just
service.
Fire?
That was just fire.
Okay.
Our police dispatch services run on the order of 100 and I'm doing this from memory, so you're going to need to use plus and minus approximate or some other way.
Just give a low estimate.
We're probably, with equipment maintenance and others, about $150,000 a year.
Just for police?
Yes.
Okay. What about fire?
85, sounds right.
Yeah, because it's gone down.
85,000? Mm-hmm. Okay. Conway?
I think ours is 350-ish. And again, I was mentioning to Carter earlier, we, you know, with five fire departments, I think I'm pretty sure police does all of that, but I'd have to check to make sure. So again, same kind of qualifications on this table that Carter made. And just to follow up with what Carter said, I think he's laid out the concern or the case pretty clearly. And again, I think what we're really looking for today is just the opportunity to sit down and work on this issue, mm-hmm. you know, with, yeah. the people that are involved and see what does make sense for everybody. You know?
Okay.
We're certainly not saying we want the county to invest in infrastructure and personnel and then we'll decide whether we want to participate.
Right. And it's not, the timing isn't right now either for budgets, right. Whether it's for town or for the county. So that $350,000, is that the total for dispatching?
Yeah, and again, that's
police and fire?
I believe it is, yeah.
It is,
okay.
Yes.
How about
$395,000, and that takes care of fire and police.
I'm sorry, what was it again?
$395,000, and that's the whole budget. I can break it out by,
okay.
you know, a stamp and all the other stuff. I think where Wolfboro comes from, and I support Carter and having a working group to kind of take a real good look at what's going on. Wolfboro is a regional center. We have the high school, we have the middle school, Voc Tech, elementary schools, a hospital, and even within our own town, we have some areas that we have a hard time getting dispatched because you've got hills.
Yeah.
You know, and at times, and I don't want to say we don't want to use any of the county services because I think there is some spots that we may even have to bounce to the county to get some stuff into Wolfboro,
right.
But it seems like we're paying a disproportionate amount for mm-hmm. the amount of service, so if we could do it based on the service we use, that would be helpful. You know, I think with the center that we have, it's important for Wolfboro to have that dispatch in the community. We have a lot of visitors from other towns coming in there for either the hospital or the schools and stuff, and we can get our services out quickly that way.
Are there any towns besides Conway, Moultonboro, and Wolfboro that are served by the county but cannot be served, say, 100% that are not in the, not here?
Don't we have one town outside the county that pays for the dispatch?
Does Sandwich have good service, for example?
Yeah. But there's one town. Is it Farmington?
Milton Fire Department, we dispatch for them, but they pay for that because they're not within the county. They're the only ones that are paid for outside of the county dollars.
I'd like to add one thing. And I was chairman of the select board in Moultonboro when we started talking about this. We talked about eliminating our dispatch, seeing how much money we could save, because everybody was looking, with the economy it was, where can we save? And we did understand from people before you that you're going to have to buy new equipment. We were going to have to put in repeaters because you couldn't hit enough of our town, and we were going to have to pay for the repeaters. And I'm sitting there on the select board saying, we are one of the three high-paying county taxes. I really don't want to try to save $100,000 or whatever on one leg of trying to say we're going to do away with our dispatch, but our county's going to go up because we're going to spend $2 million on new equipment down there plus personnel. Somewhere we need a give and take, but I don't want to... I don't want to be able to tell the townspeople we're saving money because we're having the county do our dispatch, but the county tax is going up.
Well, the county taxes would go up, but all the other towns would pay also.
Yeah, they would, but the problem is you've got the three big payers right here, and we're going to pay a good percentage of that. And unfortunately, it is the way it is, and I don't want to argue about that part of it. Okay. I'm just saying we could... Yep. Bite off our nose and spite our face if we weren't careful.
Any idea how many inmates come from individual towns? Would we be
if
looking
they
at?
From Eaton Center.
Would we? Yeah, probably.
I'm sure, and I don't think anyone from any one of these towns is arguing that there's not county things that we do use. The sheriff through the jail, serving warrants. There is stuff at the. I guess our primary concern is what we might be able to do with the dispatch part of...
Right.
We're not suggesting that every service the county provides should be put on some sort of fee-for-service basis. And if Moultonboro has more inmates in the jail than does Tuftonboro, we should be paying that sum. But we are suggesting that when services are not available equitably across the board, and when our tax dollars are being used to keep the tax dollars in other communities lower, that is essentially unfair and should be addressed in some manner.
Can I just, I apologize because I have to leave in a few minutes. And the sheriff is, you got the memo, he's more than willing to look into it and equitability and what's best for everyone and so forth. Just on a personal note, the representation about the equitability and what it's going to cost to take on Moultonboro with the towers and having a repeater, that is true. That would have to happen. I just think we have to, if we do form a committee, we have to form the committee and remember as to historically how we got to the county where we are now, how Conway, Moultonboro, and Wolfboro decided to have their own dispatch now. Everything is built. We're built now because... Our dispatch center is built now because we don't, on the way it is, so we don't have to dispatch for your three agencies. We're certainly willing to look into all possibilities. We couldn't take over Moultonboro, Conway, certainly not Conway and Wolfboro at this point in time. If it's something you want us to explore, we certainly can. We just need to know what the needs are, what you want, what the expectations are, and just caution on the county dollars as far as, you know, how many inmates you have, how many people at the nursing home, the courts and all that kind of stuff. I think it's a risky road to run down. I think it certainly, what it's going to come back to look at is why everyone's here today, and I think everything's going to come out fine. You know, I'm just afraid of maybe going down a road that's like I said, it's risky to say, okay, well, Conway has two-thirds of the inmate population, so they're going to have to pay two-thirds of the jail fees, and Moultonboro